Hey everyone, welcome back to episode 4 of Quick Compounds. Today I'm going to create a Bifrost compound that generates fuzz all over an input object. To do this, first I'm going to generate a bunch of random points on an object's surface. Then I'll find the normals at those points and generate strands that run along them. Now, traditionally I've been starting all my compounds from scratch. However, recall that my previous tutorial in this series was all about generating random points on objects. Rather than redoing that work, it'd make a lot more sense to reuse it. So I'll bring in my generate points on object compound. If you skipped the previous tutorial, you can download this compound from the link in the description below. If I hook this up to, say, a sphere, you can see it defaults to generating points all over it. This is exactly what I need for a starting point. Now, I can't edit anything in here because imported compounds like this begin in read-only mode. You can make one of these editable by right-clicking and selecting Make Editable. But I only need a small part of this compound, the part that deals with meshes. I can ignore all this volume stuff. So instead, I'm going to select just what I need and copy it. Then return to the root level and paste it here. Perfect! Now that I have what I need, I can delete my previous compound. So this generate points on mesh compound gives me a random set of positions on a mesh. Next, I need to get the normal at those points. So I'll dive inside and then create a second sample property node by again copy and pasting the one I already have. This copy will have all the same input wires, which is exactly what I want, since I'm sampling normals from the same points that are being generated. Then all I need to do is set the property to point normal. And I'll spit out the results as a second output and name the two of these appropriately. Now that I've got my point positions and respective normals, it's time to construct my points, just like the previous tutorial. Only this time, I'll need to use a setGeo property node to inject the normals into my points, like so. Now that I've got a Bifrost geometry object consisting of a bunch of points and respective normals, I can just feed that into a create strands along normals node. And output the result. And there you go, that was easy. Maybe I'll just increase the number of points to 100,000 and decrease the length to 0.1. There, that's not a bad start, but as always, we can customize to do better. First, I'll want to change the color of my fuzz. So I'll go to the hypershade and create a new AI standard hair shader called Fuzz Matte. I'll just assign it one of these presets for now. Then I can use an Assign Material node to apply my new color. And now I've got color. Next, note how uniform the fuzz is, both in terms of their orientation and length. I prefer to vary those up a bit. To do that, I'm going to need to use a couple of different methods. When it comes to direction, I'd like to generate some noise and then add it to the existing directions, which right now just follow along their normals. So I'll create a curl noise node, then feed it my point positions to generate some offsets. Once I have those offsets, I'll need to add them back to the original normals before creating my strands. And now you can see here that the strands are starting to subtly curl around a single point. This is nice and all, but a single curl doesn't really do much for me. I prefer to control the frequency of those curls. So to do that, I'll create a new value node and pre-multiply that to the point positions before feeding that into my curl noise node. This effectively amplifies the values going into it. Now I can adjust the frequency value of the curl points using this value. I'll rename it frequency just to make it clear. So frequency gives each strand a new facing direction. However, I'd also like to control how much a strand is offset in that direction. To do that, I'm going to post-multiply the noise with another value to scale up the overall effect. And now I can really accentuate the noise. However, notice that as I test higher and higher values that some of the fuzz starts to fold almost 180 degrees into my sphere, creating bald spots that look pretty awful. To fix that, I'm going to create a project vector node and plug that in between the curl noise and post multiplier I just added. Into this, I'll plug my noise as well as my original normals. This casts a projection of the noise onto the original normal directions. However, what I'm really after here is the orthogonal vector. This is the vector that runs 90 degrees to the normal. This is what I want to actually post-multiply. The reason for that is that no matter how long this vector gets, it'll never push the original normal around 180 degrees. Which in turn fixes all my interpenetrations. Now I can clean up my graph a bit by grouping these into a compound called randomize directions. Next, when it comes to tweaking length, I'll use a similar technique but apply differently. Like before, I'll generate some random noise values and then add them to a base length. Since I don't need to worry about directionality this time, I can use a simple random value array node to generate my noise. This creates an array full of values from 0 to 1. I'll need one random value for each hair, so my array size needs to be equal to the number of normals I'm generating. Then I'll multiply those random numbers with my current normal directions to get them facing the right way. It's difficult to see results in this mess, so let's temporarily remove all the directional randomization. To do that, I'll need to expose the appropriate controls on my randomized directions compound. So that does get us some randomization, however, I have no way to control the overall scale of this yet. I'll do that the exact same way as before. So first I'll create a value node again, and pre-multiply that into my random values. Then I'll add that to a base size. Basically, this will be the minimum length a strand can possibly be. And now I can scale my variance and base length. As a bit of housekeeping, I'm quickly going to pop back into my randomized directions compound and add a normalized node before the output. Normalizing will keep the directions of my normals, but force the length of each strand to 1. This just ensures that my randomized directions compound isn't adding any extra length by accident. Now I can group all these up together into another compound called randomized lengths. Finally, right now there's fuzz being put everywhere in my model. I prefer to be able to control that. To get a better idea of why that'd be useful, let me import a better model. So here on my cute Cthulhu mesh, it becomes pretty clear why I'd like to mask out specific areas from generating fuzz. I'm going to do that by using a property I showed in a previous tutorial, color per vertex data. If I go back to my generate points on mesh compound, you'll notice it has this handy enable mask option. I'll just expose that on the compound itself, along with the mask property. Now if you did my previous CBV tutorial, you should know all about how these color sets work. Like before, I'll set the mask property to color set. Then I'll flood the mesh with black CBVs. And there goes my fuzz. Now, before I paint CBVs onto my mesh, I'll need to temporarily change its material to the default Lambert in order to see the colors. Then I can start painting using my CBV tool. Now, wherever I paint white, the fuzz will be generated, and wherever I paint black, it won't. You can reduce or remove the strands during painting to speed this process up. The finish line is almost in sight now. However, notice that if I try to render right now, the fuzz appears very thick. I can better control that by adding a set strands shape node. I can set this to tube and alter the default size to something like 0.001. In fact, if I wire that into a set strands size profile node, I can even control the exact profile shape of the individual strands. See? At this point, I'm ready to combine all of this into a compound named Generate Fuzz on Mesh, and then wire up all the appropriate inputs. And of course, because all of this works at the component level, I can alter my mesh however I like and my fuzz will update on the fly. As well as keyframe the various parameters to get neat effects like this.